face it, when Kenyans and those interested in coming to Kenya think of a typical Kenyan holiday, in most cases, this involves the usual game drives in our national parks or a week or so of taking leisurely walks along our beautiful coastal beaches. Not that these activities are not exciting or fulfilling, but are they all that Kenya has to offer? To be honest, after indulging in a few too many game drives, even our long-suffering lions and cheetahs start giving us that long bored look as if wondering, "You again?" But what if I were to tell you that there are plenty of adrenaline-filled adventures available right here in Kenya, such as skydiving, jet skiing, kite surfing, paragliding, white water rafting, mountain climbing, high altitude marathon training, wild dolphin tours, hot air balloon tours, and desert safaris. You see, all these leisure activities are possible because Kenya has an amazing variety of geographic and climatic conditions, from the snow-capped Mount Kenya, pristine Indian Ocean beaches, cool and temperate highlands, humid tropical rainforests, and even harsh, beautiful deserts. As an experienced Kenyan travel and tour consultant, I will now offer you valuable advice about each of these adrenaline-filled adventures, including where and when they take place, who offers them, and rare insights about the country. But first, as a disclaimer, let me assure you viewers that I am not in any way affiliated with nor sponsored by the companies mentioned in this video. My recommendations are purely based on extensive research. Now, let us start with number one, white water rafting and kayaking. The ideal venue for white water rafting in Kenya is Rapids Camp Sagana, which is located in the scenic Central Highlands, about 2 hours drive from Nairobi. Located on River Tana, adrenaline junkies can enjoy the thrill of grade 3 to 5 rapids or the plunge into the 40-foot waterfall and the wild, raging river below. Of interest also is that the Rapids Camp has previously served as a venue for the Africa Olympic Canoe Qualifiers. According to the company's website, the rafting trip is a 12-kilometer stretch that is maneuvered under the supervision by their qualified guides. And when is the best season for rafting? This is when the river has the highest volume of water, following the long rains in March to May, and the short rains from October to November. Savage Wilderness is another leading company in white water rafting and kayaking. Number two, skydiving. Go Jump Kenya is a highly rated company offering skydiving services in Kenya. Located on the pristine Vipingo Ridge Beach Club in Kilifi near Mombasa town, the company is owned and operated by a Kenyan citizen who is the first internationally recognized skydiver instructor in Kenya. Given that safety standards in skydiving are a valid concern, it is reassuring to know that the female owner is also the first Kenyan to be certified as an internationally recognized FAA senior parachute rigger, with safety standards that are the gold standard for the industry. For the beginner, the company offers the tandem drive, which is, and I quote, the quickest and easiest way to experience the thrill of freefall with minimal training, while securely harnessed to one of our experienced and accomplished instructors. Licensed skydivers can also hone their skills there. Skydive Diani and Skydiving Kenya are also other leading companies in skydiving. Viewers, are you enjoying this video so far? If so, I would really appreciate your help in helping my channel grow by simply liking and subscribing. This way, I can devote more of my time creating this kind of content that educates you about Kenya and Africa as a whole. Now, let's go to number 3, kitesurfing. Kenya Kite is a well-established kitesurfing school located on the stunningly beautiful white sands of Diani Beach on Kenya's south coast. Diani Beach has the distinction of being rated as Africa's best beach destination for 5 years in a row. Kenya Kite offers a range of lessons for all levels of surfers, including beginners, children, groups, stand-up, self-riding, or even paddleboarders. The company website states that they have, and I quote, professional instructors highly trained in water safety and awareness, wave etiquette, board positioning, and wave knowledge who will encourage and guide you through your surfing progression. The Kite Center also provides rentals of professional equipment from manufacturers like Slingshot, Shaman, M-Day, Saw Custom Board, and SUP to those who do not have equipment. Number 4, hot air balloon safaris. Now, can you imagine the sheer thrill of floating gently in a hot air balloon as you observe below you a pride of lions resting lazily on the vast African savanna and silently praying that your balloon does not suddenly develop mechanical problems? Well, that is a typical safari experience in the Maasai Mara, a game reserve famous for the annual wild beast migration that is considered by UNESCO as one of the 7 wonders of the natural world. And it is one that far too many visitors to the park miss out on, as their focus is on the traditional game viewing from the ubiquitous safari vans. But as many who frequent Maasai Mara will testify, traffic jams are not infrequent in the park, as tour drivers rush their visitors to catch a front row seat to locations where a lion or other predators are devouring their freshly caught meal. From a hot air balloon, however, the same scene appears almost serene as you glide slowly and effortlessly by. Due to the popularity of Maasai Mara, there is no shortage of tour companies offering hot air balloon safaris. Some of the best rated on TripAdvisor are Mufasa Tours and Travel, Governor's Balloon Safaris, Hot Air Safaris, Skyship Corp Balloon Safaris, and Siri Ya Kenya Tours and Safaris. Number 5, paragliding and parasailing. Okay, I know you're scratching your head wondering, what on earth is the difference between paragliding and parasailing? The main difference between these two sports is that paragliders are not attached to any vehicle. Instead, they only use a paraglider, which is a free-flying, foot-launched aircraft. In parasailing, on the other hand, a person is towed behind a vehicle, which is usually a boat, while attached to a specially designed parachute known as a parasail. In Kenya, both sports are available, but paragliding is more popular as it does not involve having to make the long journey to the Indian Ocean coastline. The main requirements for paragliding are strong winds, the right kind of paragliding gear, and high ground. With the abundance of highland regions in Kenya, there is no shortage of paragliding locations, especially on the slopes of the Great Rift Valley. Some of the most popular are Kijabi, Mount Ololokwe, and Ndoto Mountains. The most spectacular paragliding views, however, are from the Kerio Valley. Some of the most well-known companies offering paragliding and parasailing tours are Mawingu Camp Kenya, Wild Springs Adventures, Tawi Travel, and Indigenous Kenya Safaris. Viewers, I hope you're enjoying the video. Once again, this is a kind reminder to like and subscribe. Number 6. Jet skiing. The sheer thrill of jet skiing does not come any better than on the warm and awe-inspiring beauty of Diani Beach. That is where Jet Ski Kenya, one of the leading jet skiing companies in Kenya, is located. With a focus on detail and a test drive, beginners quickly feel safe with the modern and safe jet ski, as well as the ski expert and lifeguard who always accompany every tour. As an added bonus of skiing with Jet Ski Kenya is the opportunity to ski next to their ever-loving neighbors, the dolphins of Kisite National Marine Park and Reserve. These fun-loving and gentle sea animals seem to enjoy the jet skiing trips as much as the humans do. Tribe Water Sports is another well-established company offering jet skiing and other water sports on Watamu Beach. According to the company website, Tribe Water Sports has a Mallard's Classic 210 ski boat with a 200 HP engine ready to pull all riders out of the water for the activity of choice. All sessions are also run by a BWSF ski boat driver and wakeboard or water ski instructor. Number 7. Dolphin watching. Dolphin families have lived in Watamu's protected park and reserve in Kenya for as long as the locals can remember. The Watamu Marine Association has been studying these highly intelligent marine mammals since 2010 and have so far found that over 100 different animals inhabit this area, many of them mothers and young calves. There are three species of dolphins in Watamu, which are the Indo-Pacific bottlenose dolphin, the rare Indo-Pacific humpback dolphin, and the offshore acrobats known as the spinner dolphins. As thrilling as the dolphin experience is, visitors are advised to remain in the boat as the dolphins are wild and have over 100 teeth. Other do's and don'ts of dolphin watching are: do not touch dolphins. Do not feed dolphins or throw objects into the water to attract them. Do not make sudden or loud noises like banging on the boat or shouting. This can damage their hearing and interfere with their communication, navigation, and prey location. Do not jump in and swim with the dolphins unless they come to you first and you are already in the water. Chasing dolphins to swim with them may place both you and the dolphins at risk, especially if they have young. There are several tour companies that offer dolphin watching tours in Watamu, and other areas of the Indian Ocean coastline. Some of the leading ones are Africa Kenya Safaris, Gem Finders Safaris, and Cruzeiro Safaris. Number 8. Chalbi Desert Safaris. A Chalbi Desert Safari in the wilds of northern Kenya is the ultimate unforgettable adventure for adrenaline junkies. Covering an area of 100,000 square kilometers, the Chalbi Desert is one of the hottest and most arid regions of Kenya. Although northern Kenya is a much underrated as a tourism circuit, the region has a wide array of wildlife species, vast savanna grasslands, and the only true desert in East Africa, the Chalbi Desert. This landscape boasts the Big Five, which are the lion, leopard, elephant, rhino, and buffalo, as well as the Special Five, or the Northern Five, namely the reticulated giraffe, the gravy zebra, the Geranuk, the Beisa Oryx, and the Somali Ostrich. When you journey into the Chalbi Desert, prepare yourself for an eerie landscape edged by rocky lava flows, cracked earth, and a sandy mixture of white salt and clay across which your guide carefully drives through. But even in this barren and desolate location, you may see a shadow emerge in the distance as ostriches, gravy zebras, oryx, and other adapted animals are often observed in the desert. The Chalbi Desert, though, does have a secret. On the northern edge is a stunningly beautiful area of oases with groves of palm trees that attract sand grouse and other birds, including vulturine guinea fowls. The oases are also used by the local Gabra people as water sources for their camels. Some of the tour companies that offer safaris to Chalbi Desert are Chalbi Desert Safaris, Expeditions Maasai Safaris, and View Travel. Number 9. Mountaineering or mountain climbing. Mount Kenya is the second highest mountain in Africa and one of the few snow-capped mountains in the world that stand on the equator. The highest peaks of the mountain are Batian at 5,199 meters or 17,057 feet. Nelion at 5,188 meters or 17,021 feet. And lastly, Point Lenana at 4,985 meters or 16,355 feet. Mount Kenya, therefore, is suitable for amateur climbers as well as highly experienced mountaineers. It is worth pointing out, though, that a healthy level of physical fitness is still required for all levels. Many alpine species are endemic to Mount Kenya, such as the giant lobelias, senecios, and a local subspecies of rock hyrax. Due to this unique biodiversity, an area of 715 square kilometers around the center of the mountain was designated as a national park and listed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1997. Some of the most experienced companies that offer tours to Mount Kenya are Go to Mount Kenya, Hyrax Safaris, and Equatorial Star Adventures and Safaris. Number 10, high altitude marathon training. And how about the opportunity to train with some of Kenya's unbeatable marathon champions on their own turf and maybe learn a lesson or two about their prowess. By far the most well-known amongst these facilities for elite athletes is the High Altitude Training Center in Iten Town. Iten is quite accurately known as the home of champions due to its track record of producing homegrown long-distance athletes. And in case you're wondering if a camp for the world's best long-distance athletes accepts those who merely run as a hobby, fear not. The company's website reassuringly proclaims that the camp is open for everyone. It further states that the High Altitude Training Center was founded in 1999 by Lorna Kiplagat. Lorna Kiplagat is a 4-times world champion. She has held world records for 5,000, 10,000, 20,000 and half marathon and competed for the Netherlands in the Athens, Beijing and London Olympics. She also won the World Championship Cross Country in Mombasa in 2007 and competed in the 2003 World Championship Tracks. Now, it doesn't get better than that for budding marathoners. So, hold on to your dream, put on your running shoes and head to Iten. And that's it, viewers. I really appreciate your viewing this video to the end. I would very much like to continue making more of these kinds of videos that showcase the incredible beauty of Kenya and the many thrilling leisure activities available. Please help me do this by liking and subscribing to my channel. And look out for the next one.